Hello, everyone. Today, we are going to learn about the estimation of NaOH and Na₂CO₃ in a mixture of the two. This experiment is based on the selective use of indicators. It depends on the fact that sodium hydroxide reacts with an acid in a single step, while sodium carbonate reacts in two steps. Let's see the reactions one by one. First reaction, NaOH plus HCl gives NaCl and water. Second reaction, Na₂CO₃ plus HCl gives NaHCO₃ and NaCl. Third reaction, NaHCO₃ plus HCl gives NaCl, water, and carbon dioxide. Now here's the interesting part. Phenolphthalein acts successfully as an indicator only for reaction 1 and 2. But as soon as reaction 3 begins, the liberated carbon dioxide removes the color of the indicator, and phenolphthalein loses its function. At this stage, if we use methyl orange as the indicator and continue titrating with the same standard acid, the volume of acid consumed will indicate the completion of the third reaction. The volume of acid used with phenolphthalein corresponds to the entire amount of sodium hydroxide and half of sodium carbonate. Let this volume be called V1. The other half of sodium carbonate is neutralized during the titration with methyl orange, and the volume used here is called V2. So the difference, V1 minus V2, gives us the volume of acid that is equivalent to the sodium hydroxide present in the mixture.
Procedure: take 25 milliliters of the supplied mixture in a conical flask. Add 1 to 2 drops of phenolphthalein and titrate against standard hydrochloric acid. The endpoint will be known by the disappearance of pink color of the solution to just
colorless. Note the endpoint. Then add a drop of methyl orange to the SARN colorless solution in the conical flask. Titrate the solution again with the same standard acid. The endpoint will be denoted by the change of color of the solution from yellow to pink. Note the endpoint. Repeat the titration to take at least 2 to 3 concurrent readings. Now let's understand the observation table, which records the burette readings for both indicators.
Phenolphthalein indicator, columns 3 to 6.
25 mL of alkali mixture was used. The readings are as follows. Observation 1, initial 0.0, final 19.0, difference 19.0 mL. Observation 2, 25.4, 44.2 equals 18.8. Observation 3, 6.4, 25.1 equals 18.7. Observation 4, 0.0, 18.7 equals 18.7. So the average volume of acid used with phenolphthalein indicator is 18.7.
Methyl orange indicator, columns 7 to 10.
Now let's look at the readings after adding methyl orange and continuing the titration. Observation 1, 19.0, 25.4 equals 6.4 mils. Observation 2, 0.0, 6.4 equals 6.4 mils. Observation 3, 25.1 at 31.4 equals 6.3 mils. Observation 4, 18.7, 52.0 equals 6.3 mils. So the average volume of acid required after the phenolphthalein endpoint using methyl orange is 6.3 mils.
Let's calculate the volume of acid required to neutralize a mixture of sodium hydroxide, NaOH, and sodium carbonate. Let the volume of acid required to neutralize the total amount of NaOH and half of Na₂CO₃ in 25 milliliters of the mixture be V1 equals 18.7 milliliters. And the volume of acid required to neutralize half of Na₂CO₃ in 25 milliliters of the mixture be V2 equals 6.3 milliliters. One volume of the acid required to neutralize whole of NaOH in 25 milliliters of the mixture equals V1 minus V2 equals 18.7 minus 6.3 equals 12.4 milliliters. Volume of the acid required to neutralize whole of Na₂CO₃ in 25 milliliters of the mixture equals 2V2 equals 2 times 6.3 equals 12.6 milliliters. Now for NaOH calculation. We know that 25 milliliters of the alkali mixture requires 12.4 milliliters of N/10 HCl with the factor F equals 0.99. So for 1000 milliliters, we apply the formula 12.4 times 0.99 times 1000 divided by 25 times 10. Calculating this gives 49.1 milliliters of normal HCl. Therefore, the amount of NaOH present is also 49.1 milliliters of normal NaOH. We know that 1,000 milliliters of normal NaOH solution contains 40 grams of NaOH. Now, to find out how much NaOH is present in 49.1 milliliters, we use the formula 40 times 49.1 divided by 1,000. This gives us 1.964 grams of NaOH. Now, for sodium carbonate, in this case, 25 milliliters of the alkali mixture require 12.6 milliliters of N/10 HCl, with a correction factor F equals 0.99. To calculate for 1,000 milliliters, use the formula 12.6 times 0.99 times 1,000, divided by 25 times 10. This gives 49.896 milliliters of normal HCl, which is equivalent to 49.896 milliliters of normal Na₂CO₃. We also know that 1,000 milliliters of normal sodium carbonate solution contains 53 grams of sodium carbonate. To find out how much is present in 49.896 milliliters, we use the formula 53 times 49.896 divided by 1,000. This gives us 2.645 grams of sodium carbonate. Conclusion: therefore, 1,000 milliliters of the alkali mixture contains 1.964 grams of sodium hydroxide and 2.645 grams of sodium carbonate. And that brings us to the end of this practical explanation. Let me clarify, Leica, this is not just something I wrote in my own copy. All the content shown in this video is taken from a reputed reference book, so you can confidently write the same in your practical notebook. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like the video, share it with your classmates, comment below if you have any questions or doubts, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more accurate and exam-based content. Thanks for watching. All the best for your practicals, and see you in the next video.